I feel like I know one of them. This is based on your closing space, so it's Angie Stone.
Angie Stone, yeah. So this record basically is a tip to the head of music I grew up with, and the backing track is from a band called by the OJs. That's called Backstabbers.
Right. Okay.
So when you first hear that track, that's what you hear as a sample first.
Wow, I didn't know that.
So at the beginning, you think, oh, they're going to play Backstabbers. Yeah. And then she sings, yeah. Think, hang on, what's that? And it goes into the song.
Right. Same old story back
again. I just thought, wow, that's just amazing, because there's no other way of reproducing that backing track at all unless you've got the OJs.
Of course, so, yeah, it's all live elements.
Because
yeah,
it's all live.
Electronic.
No, it's all in there, the musicianship. So they were very clever to leave that in. But here's the thing. I didn't know what I was going to play at Space as a last
really?
Record.
Right.
Until 2 days before. And I could have played anything I wanted. You know, Promised Land or Strings of Life or, you know, yeah. All the obvious stuff. And I really was struggling with the last record. I was in a restaurant. I was at Cipriani's at the time. And the DJ there, he played it. And I was like, I said, bloody hell, Angie Stone. That's the
universe, Carl.
I can't.
That's the sign from the universe.
I couldn't believe that it came to me in that way. Now, I'm not known for playing that style of music in that arena. I have never played that record before, ever, in any sets, in the radio, nothing.
Yeah.
It literally was like, this is getting played.
Yeah.
Bang. But what I did also, I put it through Ableton, put a kick drum on it.
Yes. Just to get it a bit more heavy, a bit just, clubby.
Yeah, a bit more clubby, and put hi-hat, a bit of rides in it. Yeah. I did some filters on it. That was my mix of the re-edit of that track. And when I played it, people still didn't think that I had done it. They still think it was another remix for someone
really?
Else.
Really, right. Okay.
But I just did those touches on it and kept everything original. When I did the 9 or 10 hour set of Space on my own night, you would have heard all the music that I was associated with for all the years I played there at that night.
Yeah.
So that last record was like a cleanser in some ways. Wow, on that big system, the way how people felt, the emotions of it all. Another record of that I like to play, if I can, is Promised Land by Joe Smooth. It came out in 1988-89, it was right there on the Summer of Love. You always kind of heard that record near the end of the night.
Yeah.
Brought everyone together, you started singing the song from the top of your voice to be able to still play it today, knowing what it meant to me when it first came out. The record still stands up and holds up today, which I think is really amazing.
Yeah.
And the other one is probably a bit of a shock, but it's a Soul to Soul, Back to Life.
Really? Yeah. Right, yeah, I like that. Take back to life,
back to reality. It's a down-tempo groover, but it's got a good bass line, makes you feel good, happy. You know, you walk away, you know, you've heard everything in the
Absolutely.
Night.
Absolutely.
And you hear this. And you know, you said about.
You know what? I feel like I've seen someone do that recently, and they must have stole it off you, wouldn't they? I need to figure out where I've seen that.